Ohio, home to the Bobcats of Ohio U. We're looking forward to a full house and a terrific game in this one. Today, an intra-conference battle between a couple of MAC rivals. As we'll see, the Eastern Michigan Eagles taking on the Ohio Bobcats. Glad to have you with us for EA Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack, and Jesse Palmer with me in the booth. Guys, we are ready to tee it up. Eastern Michigan ready to kick it off and get this game going. He'll bring it back from inside his five. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. So Ohio's offense takes the field to start this game off. And when you take the field with the confidence, the swag that this guy does, David, it just really elevates your confidence in the passing game.
That receivers don't usually lack confidence, and those are the guys that kind of set the tone. That swagger sets the tone for this offense, and Jesse, you know he's going to make plays.
And that speed scares defenses, too, because he can take the top off quick. These safeties better get back deep, or else this guy's going to take it to the house.
They'll leave it with him. Dragged down after a pickup of five out to the 35. Halfway there on first down, it's second and five. On the move. And he'll pick up the first down after a tough run there. And the Bobcats come to the line with a new set of downs. Out of the gun, the running back has it. And a pickup of eight opens a world of opportunities on second and two. Went with the running game on first down, now back at it. The give from the gun. They'll get him stopped at the 34. He's got 10 yards on that one and a first down.
I think it's really important for this offense. They get this guy going early in the game, and they're doing a nice job of that right now. Remember, he's the kind of running back who gets better as the game goes on. That's a really good omen for this offense, considering his success now early.
Off the play fake on first down to throw. Can't make the grab. Quarterback just missed him a little bit. And the incompletion brings up a second down. Power football with the run. Fighting off the defender. Pulled down at the 29 after getting five. Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but now facing third down. Grabbed in the middle, it's Harris. There to make the tackle, but the big throw is good enough to give them a first down. The Bobcats have pushed it inside the 20. He's got it on the move. They'll get it down to the 8-yard line on that throw and catch, and the defense is backed up against the wall. Running back searching for a hole. They get him stopped at the 5-yard line, but it will be first and goal from there. Defense is backed up. Shadow of the goalpost trying to defend their own end zone. And he got nothing, and the line of scrimmage is still the 5-yard line. Can the defense stop them again on second and goal? Looking for a man. It's Navarro. He caught it. He's down at the one, and they almost had the touchdown pass on that one. They've moved it right to the precipice of a score, and they need one more yard. So the decision has been made, and the coach will take the penalty. This defense has given up yards, but a chance to make a stop on this opening drive on third and goal. Didn't put much on that one, and it's incomplete. It's fourth down, and they'll try the field goal. And this one shouldn't be too taxing, a 23-yard try. It's good. He could have hit a string right in the middle of the uprights there. And that'll put the first points of the game on the board. It's 3-0.
Well, this team knew coming into tonight's game, they had to get momentum early, playing at home. They want to get the crowd into it. So you get a beautiful drive here to start this thing. You would have liked to cap it off with a touchdown, but listen, you set yourself up for a field goal. You knock it through the uprights. You've got the lead. Everything right now looking good.
He'll start the return inside his five. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. So Eastern Michigan's offense will go to work for the first time. Here are our impact players for this game, and it goes beyond executing an assignment to make an impact in the game.
Yeah, obviously we were talking to both coaching staffs this week, and we asked them who needs to step up and play well. They immediately pointed to these guys right here. They are the key for their respective teams.
Yeah, and they don't always show up in the box score, but these are the guys that are the leaders. These are the guys getting everybody organized and have to play well for their team to succeed.
Snagged on the outside, it's Singleton. And that defense doesn't allow a cutback, and they get him out of bounds after a short gain. We've come to the end of the quarter, and Ohio is on top. We've played one. Before we move on, let's have a look at the stats. Now to see if these guys can get back in the game in the second quarter. They'll try to muscle their way forward on third and short from the 29. They'll try to get it through the air. Just a short pass to the tight end. And the Eagles get the first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. Finds enough room to get three out to the 34. Got three on first down at second and seven. From the gun, the ground game. They stop him cold, maybe gets a yard to the 34. Coming to the line of scrimmage on third down. Back to pass, it's Snyder. He's right on target. And they reacted well to the completion, but it was too late to keep him from getting the first down. He leaves it with his back. Now they're starting to feel it. They've got a first down at the 44. Eastern Michigan has it and a fresh set of downs. Right back to the well. And a good, solid pickup before the defense cuts him down. After the productive first down play, it's second and six. Grab near the marker. It's Singleton. Into the end zone unimpeded, except for that piece of laundry on the field. This might be coming back. The officials offer the deal, and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. He wants to throw here on second down. Quickly out to the tight end. And that corner came in hot despite knowing that he was giving up some size. They try to pop a run on the draw. And the defense had its hands full, but they finally wrestle him down short of the first down. And they'll have to settle for a field goal try. And it's no good. He missed it. And after the miss, they're still down by a field goal. The Ohio U offense returns to the field. And to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse, they'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to execution, too. Did a nice job out in the field, stalled a little bit once they got down to the goal line, so they just need to be a little bit more crisp here, Dave.
Yeah, and listen, I think the first part was the most important part. You got to put the drive together first to get down there. Now, when we get down there, focus on execution and getting 6 points.
They can rely on this guy to pick up solid yardage when they need it, and he's out to the 43. Dropping back, it's Navarro. And this is dropped. Incomplete pass. He had a huge gain in his fingers, and he couldn't hold on. Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. On the return, it's Singleton. He gets it up to the 34-yard line before he stopped, and that's where the offense will set up shop. Line gets set, first down. They'll start this drive with a pass. They're bringing heat. He's got the back in the middle. And so you got a guy who makes a play downfield like that, How anxious do you think they're going to be to continue in man coverage?
Yeah, I don't know, Reese. They're going to need a plan. They're going to maybe want to think about more zone coverage or maybe even bracketing this running back if he decides to come out of the backfield, because right now they don't seem to have an answer for him.
They'll rush to the line. Clock stopped for the first down. They'll set the chains and wind the clock. It's complete. And a big-time grab there. Knocked down immediately, but not before he gets it to the 40. A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. Throws to the wideout. It's complete. And chunk plays are the name of the game, and they get one here before the defense finally makes a stop. From the red zone, looking for a man. And it's caught. Touchdown, Eagles!
One of the areas they really focused on with this receiver in the offseason was, we need you to make more plays for us in the end zone. When we're taking shots, we need you to be able to step up and make tough catches. And David, what a grab right there.
And I think a lot of that has to do with trusting your guy, knowing where he's going to be, knowing when he's going to sit down, when he's not. So being on the same page, and then having a guy that can go get it. Just when the ball is near him, he's going to make the play, just like he did right there for 6 points.
And the extra point is good, and it's a 4-point lead. A very efficient 5-play scoring drive. And the capper, a 19-yard toss for the touchdown. On the run from inside his own 5. And good work by the coverage team to get the return man down on the ground. Ohio U ready to go back to work on offense. This late in the half, you're behind. You'd love to create something before the break to build momentum, Jesse.
Well, you've also had some miscues on offense, a big part of why you're losing the game right now. I'd take it into halftime, make my adjustments, and come out ready in the second half.
Yeah, I'm going to take it into halftime too, Palmer. But I'm trying to put some points up right here. Be aggressive, set the tone, be like, hey, listen, this is what you're going to get in the second half, so find something really quick that you can go to.
We've played 2 quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Guys, who's had a better seat there in Athens, Ohio, for an entertaining first half than you? Here's a quick recap. And it's been said football is a game of inches, and guess what? Based on the comparison between third down conversion rate today and the average yard per play, how can you argue that? I mean, the low-lying fruit is to look at some of the explosive plays we've seen and panic. But really, this game is going to come down to which team is more efficient when they have the ball and how they play when it matters most. And with that, let's send it back to our men at Peden Stadium.
And he takes this from inside the 5. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Keeping it on the ground to open the second half. Got it across the 20 and out to the 23, a pickup of 4. Solid pickup of 4 on first down at 2nd and 6. Now the play fake. That's caught. It's Mitchell. And he'll be marked down right there, still short of the first down. Facing a third down and short from the 26. Pocket starts to collapse. Fires to the big fella. He's going to have enough to pick up the first down as they stop him at the 33-yard line. The Eagles come to the line with a fresh set of downs. They'll run it from the gun. Just willed his way for a couple out to the 35. Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. He'll keep it himself. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry. Now facing a 3rd and long. Dropping back, it's Snyder. Unloads to the right. And they fail to hook up on 3rd down. Eastern Michigan will be forced to punt. He'll bring it back. It's Owen. And he'll work his way on the return out to the 35-yard line before he stops. Ohio takes over. The Bobcat offense heads to the field. From the gun. Give on the inside. And in a low-scoring game like this one, David, every possession is magnified.
And I think more than anything, it just gets frustrating. And you got to put that behind you. You got to see what this defense has been doing to be so successful. Palmer, now use it against him.
Yeah, David, I think for a play caller, this is tough, right? It's like you have to have the perfect play on just to get a first down. In these types of games, I think you're just trying to get guys out in space, see if a dude can break a tackle. Maybe that generates an explosive play, and it breaks this trend.
Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. Gives it to the back on the draw. A strong tackle and wrap up from the junior. A third and long coming up here. From the gun, wants to pass. Looking down the middle. Complete downfield. And they'll finally catch up to him, but not before a big chunk of yardage is picked up.
Hey, nice job by the offense there, attacking the middle of the field. Excellent route, finding the soft spot in the defense. Nice job by the quarterback putting it right on his gun.
And the Bobcats look to keep this drive humming. Looking to go up top on first down. Got it in the middle, it's Owen. Didn't pick up a lot there, moved it forward just a few. Second down coming up on this red zone opportunity. He's looking to throw. He's got it! Touchdown, Ohio! And with that, they've got the lead here in the second half.
And that's why this running back is so dangerous. It's not just handing him off the football, but he's a weapon in the passing game. You see his ability to catch it, turn upfield, make people miss, and find the end zone.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And the extra point puts them up by a field goal. They put together a 65-yard drive for the score. And they finish it off by connecting from 10 yards out. Here he comes from inside his own five. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. Eastern Michigan has it back as the Eagle offense returns to the field. The sledding has been tough. Scores have been at a premium. He lobs one high down the left side. And he's got it inside the 20. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped. They just changed the dynamic of this possession in a heartbeat, and now it's first and 10 from inside the red zone. To the ground with the back. Working his way and keeping those legs moving, picks up five down to the 14. Going to work on second down in the red zone, and still some ground to cover to pick up that first down. We've come to the end of the quarter, and Ohio is on top. Three quarters are in the books. Time becomes a factor both in trying to hold the lead or cut into it as we take a look at the stats. One more period to go to see who can make the winning plays and come home with the victory. To the air, it's Snyder. Getting some heat. And they get to the quarterback and knock him down back at the 16.
Well, quarterback went down behind center pretty quick that time, and it makes you wonder as a play caller, against this pass rush, do you start thinking about maybe rolling your quarterback out and changing the launch point?
They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. Here's the handoff. Almost got to the sticks on third down, able to pick up six, but they're looking at a fourth and one. And now on fourth down, they will put it on the shoulders of the kicker to save them with his foot. Field goal is good. And guys, we are deadlocked here in the final period. Here comes the kickoff as we are all tied up in the fourth quarter. On the move from inside his five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The Ohio U offense returns to the field. Off play action on first down. And it's incomplete. If you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well hang on to the ball. Offense gets set for second down. After the incompletion, back to the passing game. He's going to let one fly down the middle. And the incomplete pass taking a shot on second down, and they'll be left with a third down. Wants to throw. It's Navarro. Didn't have anything working and just had to throw it away on third down. The Bobcats send out the punt unit. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. He's got great speed. He was able to get that ball up to the 48-yard line before he stopped on the return. They'll start this drive at their own 48. Leaves it with the back. At the 40, there he goes. And this defense's head is spinning. He gets it down to the 27.
When you talk about creating big plays in the running game like this, this makes the game really easy. Actually, when you've got a guy like this that you can hand it to with this much speed and elusiveness, just hard to bring down in the open field, what a big game for the offense.
They'll put it in play from the 27, first down. Might as well give it to him again. And he almost ran away from everybody on that one. A huge pickup on that play. And the offense is so close to the go-ahead score, they can smell it here in the fourth quarter. It's complete! They go up top to get it down to the 5-yard line as they try to pay off this drive. Fast motion from the offense. Quick pass on the jet motion. And he has a solid gain before the defense bottles him up. If they can pay off this third and goal opportunity, man, oh, man, those collars start getting a little. Touchdown, Eastern Michigan. And with that, they move out front here in the fourth.
And I love the physicality of this offense. It's third and goal. It's money time. I've got to be more physical than you. And that's exactly what this offense just did. Put the ball on the ground and put it in the end zone.
Lining up to add another. The extra point is good, and now in the fourth, they're up by a touchdown and an extra point. A very efficient five-play scoring drive. And they finish it off with a short plunge into the end zone. He'll bring it back from inside his five. And good work by the coverage team to knock down the return man. Ohio U ready to go back to work on offense. Quarterback on the keeper. And how about that interior defense stuffing the run for nothing? Now on second down. Back to throw, it's Navarro. Quickly complete. And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short gain. If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. On third and long, trying to have a big completion here. Didn't have much room to run and not a whole lot of help. Short gain there and still plenty of ground to cover for the first down. We've reached a 2-minute warning and the defense needs to come up with a stop to close this thing out. Got it past the marker. They immediately call timeout, trying to preserve every second they can to try to rally here late. And the Bobcats have it with a first and 10. He's gonna pass. Snagged in the middle, it's Dennis. That is exactly what you're looking for when you talk explosive plays. The defense finally able to make the stop. Big drive for this offense late, trying to tie the game. They've pieced together a couple of first downs, and here they come again. The short hands, it's Williams. Makes that one pay off, and they finally get him down at the 38. It'll be first down. They want to just keep throwing it. Just had to get rid of that one. Good job to fight another play. And after the incompletion on first down, this offense looking at second down. They want to throw it. Fires left. Makes the grab. Makes the stop at the 23-yard line, but it's a pickup of 15. A first down, and this offense is smelling the end zone. Clock stops momentarily for the first down. They'll hurry to the line. Looking downfield, it's Navarro. Unloads to the wideout. He's got an open man. Touchdown, Bobcats! A great catch and run for six.
Massive score, now massive decision-making. Obviously, extra point ties the football game. Easy peasy, nice job. A two-point conversion, you win this thing. So I would kick it, but you know what? If you want to go for it, it's your decision.
So you think this is automatic? They need this one badly. And no problem on that extra point, and we have a tie ball game here in the fourth. After that latest answer tied things up, just about set to kick it away again. He'll bring it out. It's McMillan. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Eastern Michigan takes over as the offense heads to the field. Out of the gun, the give to the back. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Sprinting to the line to try to get this one off. Clock's running. On second down, wants to throw. It's complete to the left. And they wrap him up, but not before he gets enough on the catch for the first down. We've got a timeout on the field, and we are set up for a terrific finish. Going up top on first down. Zings it complete to the right, and he'll run across the sidelines after the good gain. Let's see what they've got on second down. He's looking to throw. He's going to run it, and he's brought down at the 40-yard line, and that'll be a first down. The offense will use a timeout. Clock is stopped with 22 seconds left. Looking to throw, it's Snyder. Completes it in the middle. Timeout called by the offense. We have 18 seconds left.
Well, and a nice job working the middle of the field. I think it's so important to keep defenses honest, and you can't just dink and dunk outside. You got to work the middle. Great job finding this wide receiver over the middle of the field.
That pressure got to him, and he just had to chuck it out of bounds. This defense will try to force a fourth down on third and short from the 45. From the gun, wants to pass. Didn't have much of a choice, just had to throw that one away. It'll be fourth down. Eastern Michigan will be forced to punt. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. Solid punt, headed toward the sideline, trying to make it tough to return. The offense set for a first down play. They'll run it from the gun. Good vision and determination there to find his way up to the 23. Four quarters, not enough to settle this one. We're headed to overtime.
And these teams have played so well, back and forth, evenly contested game. How about a little free football, Jesse?
Yeah, I love this, David. Free football. I'm finding out which of these two teams is the most mature. Who can settle down now with the game on the line and make the big play?
All right, guys, so here we go in overtime, and just to refresh everyone's memory, alternating possessions starting on the opponent's 25.
And it's so nice to be on defense first, to set the tone, to understand what you need. Try to hold them to a field goal. The offense knows they can do their job to go out and get a win. Just two possessions, Palmer, like you got to be at your best.
Yeah, and I love the new rules, too, because in the third overtime possession, it goes to alternating two-point plays back and forth. Who's got anything left in the tank here in OT?
He's there to make the stop, but not before he sets up this offense first and goal from the 7. They'll try to get it in with the run. Touchdown, Eagles! And they're on top here in overtime.
Wow, this offense, they have a lot of faith in this running back. Knowing if they get down in this area of the field, he can get it done and he can answer the bell. 2 rushing touchdowns already for this offense.
The all-important extra point would push this lead to 7. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. They know what's in front of them. They have to answer that score with a touchdown. He'll come out throwing on first down. With the catch, it's Williams. And he goes out of bounds after a nice pickup on that one. On second down, he'll fire. Works the middle of the field. And the defense makes the immediate tackle, but he has enough for the first down. He's looking to throw it. Touchdown, Bobcats! They got it in the end zone. Now a decision to make with a point after.
Obviously, very hard to complete passes this area of the field. Nice execution. Now you're down by 1, and now you got to make the decision. Are we going to go for it and try to end the game right here and put this game in our offense's hands? What do you think?
And that's why I love having the ball second, because I get the opportunity to do this. I knew they scored a touchdown. We scored a touchdown. Now, do I want to go for the win, or do I want to continue this game on? It's so nice to have the ball second.
They need this extra point to send it to double overtime, and they tacked on the extra point. Down here in the second overtime period. Handoff to the single running back. And they try the middle of this stout defense and they rise to the challenge. They got nothing on the last play. It's 2nd and 10. Looking to throw, it's Navarro. Right down the middle. Wide open downfield. They make the tackle, but he's got a fresh set of downs and it's 1st and goal from the 7. This thing has been back and forth now. 1st and goal as they try to take the lead in overtime number 2. And he's able to find a little bit of running room before they get him down. And after the really good gain on 1st down, they'll try to finish it off on 2nd and goal. Touchdown, Ohio! Got it in to take the lead here in the 2nd OT.
The best running backs are the guys that can just sniff out the end zone. That running back showed you all of his freakish ability on that play.
Now in the 2nd overtime, you must go for the 2-point conversion. He's looking to throw. They can't convert, and the lead remains at 6, and now they'll have to go on defense. Now on 1st down, they need to answer with a touchdown. Trying to find his man on 1st down. Can't find his man as he took a shot trying to deliver that football, and it'll be 2nd down. He's looking to throw. Shoots it to the left. He makes a catch. Gets out of bounds after the big game, but they've got it 1st and goal. Looking to move it through the air. Makes the catch. Crisp execution in the passing game, and they've got it down to the 3.
I'll say this, man. In college football, you see a lot of bad tackling. You didn't see it right there. That was an awesome job. First off, being there at the point of attack. Once the tight end made the catch, there was no doubt he was going down. Great job, form tackle.
They've got it down to the 3. Now it's 2nd and goal. Got it. Touchdown, Eastern Michigan. And what a great response here in overtime.
offense slips the running back out of the backfield. Nobody decides to cover him. My man makes the play, shows off the hands first, got to make the catch first, does the rest, walks in the end zone for the touchdown.
Have to go for two, starting in double overtime, and this one would win the game. To the air, it's Snyder. He got it! 2-point try is good, and we'll keep playing football in triple overtime.